Insurgent Colorado Senate candidate Andrew Romanoff managed to beat four other Democratic candidates by 25 points in Colorado's Democratic caucus. Those opponents include DSCC-backed contender, former Colorado Governor John Hickenlooper.
Romanoff's campaign has called the DSCC the, quote, Democratic Death Star. A recent profile of the candidate remarked that in the Star Wars movies, Death Stars were fearsome war machines capable of blasting entire planets to smithereens, and yet, as we demonstrate time and time again, they weren't invincible. So Andrew Romanoff joins us now via Skype to talk about his grassroots campaign. Andrew, it's great to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you both. I really appreciate it.
Absolutely. So, Andrew, one thing I'm interested in, I think I was a little confused when Krystal told me that you won the Democratic caucuses. What does that mean? Is it like step one to becoming the eventual nominee? How does this all work?
Yes, you may need paper and pencil for this. Colorado has designed a fairly Byzantine path to the nomination. So what it means is that we'll be on the ballot in June. On June 30th, Colorado conducts a mail-in primary. Primary, in our case, is open to every Democrat and an affiliated voter in the state. You need 30% of the vote at the caucuses. We ended up with 55. There's some other candidates who will try to petition their way onto the ballot. And I think also what it means is that even though we got massively outspent by the DSCC and the Washington establishment, we won among the voters who are most attuned to this race. So it's encouraging to me.
Yeah, and what do you attribute that to? What was it about your message that they responded to? Because, I mean, we've been talking for a while. You've been keeping me up to date about your campaign. And Hickenlooper seems like a big force in Colorado, a big force within the Democratic Party in Colorado. What was it you were able to do, and what was the message that really resonated?
I think the force is with us. what it means is that if you run on a bold, progressive platform, in our case, campaigning for a Green New Deal and Medicare for All, if you make the case, if you even show up, I mean, one of the differences in this race is that Hickenlooper has chosen to skip 19 of our debates so far. I tell folks all the time, if you wanted a senator who didn't show up or answer questions, we've already got one named Cory Gardner. So if you say what you believe, if you meet voters where they are, or in this case now electronically, you win. And the good news is even a generic Democrat right now beats Cory Gardner by 11 points. What we're suggesting, what we're demanding, is that Coloradans choose more than a generic Democrat.
So that's an interesting point there, Andrew. But do you worry that with all of the developments right now with coronavirus and all that, it seems to have really thrown a wrench into so much of modern day politics, and people are defaulting to a person that they know, high name ID and all of that. How are you planning to overcome that obstacle?
Well, we're obviously deeply concerned about the health of our staff and the public, so we've changed our approach to campaigning. We've canceled our house parties. We're trying to virtualize this operation. In fact, we're hosting a town hall meeting on mental health and the coronavirus. I ran a mental health organization for the last 4 years. So if you're interested on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram Live, you can go to Romanoff 2020 this Wednesday, the 18th at 12 p.m. noon Mountain, 2 p.m. Eastern, and we'll have a conversation with mental health experts. So look, I recognize that candidates are going to have to change their campaigns. That's the least of the challenges that are presented by this pandemic. But at the end of the day, I think what voters want to know is, when you get to public office, who are you looking out for? Who are you going to fight for? Are you willing to stand up to your own party when the going gets tough? I'm doing that right now by running, despite the wishes of the national political establishment.
Uh-huh. And I just don't understand why the party gets involved in primary races, frankly, at all. Why not let the voters have their say and then, okay, you've got your man or woman, like, let's get in behind them and try to get them to victory on Election Day. Why did the DSCC decide to line up behind Hickenlooper?
Well, obviously, that's a question better put to Chuck Schumer. I agree with you. It's entirely inappropriate for the DSCC or any of these national party outfits to put their thumbs on the scale of a race like this. And it seems to have backfired. A lot of folks tell us they find the DSCC's involvement in this race inappropriate. I certainly do. The good news is, in winning the caucuses, we saw a spike in contributions. A lot of folks have gone to AndrewRomanoff.com. I hope some of your viewers will, too, because we are going to be up against a mountain of corporate cash. The advertising that's coming out of the other side will dwarf what resources we can put together. But Chuck Schumer doesn't actually vote in Colorado. He just acts that way.
Well, certainly interesting. We'll keep an eye on it. As it's a big development across the country, and we appreciate you joining us, Andrew.
Thanks so much.
Thank you both.
And we'll have more Rising for you after this.